Hey everybody, it's Brad with the Big Family Homestead, and in this video I'm going to show you how to make charcoal. But not just that, with one more step further I'm going to teach you how to make biochar. So here we go. Okay now, charcoal, I understand, I know what you do with charcoal, you use it in the grill, yada yada yippee skippy, but what the heck is biochar? Well, without getting too crazy in depth, biochar is basically when you take that carbon, the charcoal, and you get it inoculated with fertilizer and it will become an amazing, amazing implement for your garden. Now, basically, scientists, well, you know, interchangeably, they're both, right? Found that down in the South American cultures of these massive Incans and Mayan civilizations, that the soil was incredibly better than they had expected. And they found that they were using this biochar and putting it into the ground and using it as a fertilizer, and that is how they sustained such massive, massive cultures of people in very tight spaces. So when, in my own experience, using biochar in the garden, in all honesty, Scout's honor, I've seen about 40% increases in my output of fruits and vegetables and yada yada yippee skippy. So look into it, it works for us, it's killer, and it's easy to do, and I'm gonna show you right now how to do it. Okay, first things first, you're gonna need two steel drums. I've got a 55-gallon biggie one here, and a little one that's probably about a 30-gallon. Next, you're gonna fill up the little drum with whatever wood you wanna use that's actually gonna make the charcoal and slash or biochar. Next, you're gonna load the smaller barrel into the bigger burn barrel. I found that if you just dump it over on its side and slide it in, that works pretty well, and then you're gonna wanna get it really centered up as much as you can, because we're gonna load this up with wood to make a sort of oven effect, and we're gonna be achieving what is technically called pyrolysis. So yeah. One more thing to point out about this burn barrel is you've gotta have air vent holes so that the oxygen gets sucked in from outside and burns up. Now you're gonna wanna start loading wood into the barrel. You're gonna wanna make sure that you get it all around that inner burn chamber, all the way down to the bottom. Don't pack it in too incredibly tight because you want to be able to get a nice fire. And also, you can actually use an accelerant to start your fire because it's not going to matter. All of it, everything's going to be burned up except for the carbon. The carbon's the only thing that's going to be left. And what you do is you just basically tend your fire. Just make sure that it's all good and it's all burning. You kind of keep things moving down towards the sides. So what's happening right now inside that inner burn chamber is as it heats up, like that oven effect, all of the gases that are flammable are being burned off and it's being turned into pure carbon. And so once that's done, this is gonna take about three-ish hours, four-ish hours. Once that's done, we let everything burn completely down and completely out. Then you let it cool down, you dump it over, and you've got charcoal. So after your burn is done and you've let it cool down for a few hours, what you're left with is this, chunks of perfect charcoal. Now, if you wanna use this in the barbecue or however you wanna use it to cook with or heat with, that's fine and dandy, you're done. You just use it how you'd use it. But if you wanna take it to the next step to make biochar, there's only one more step that you've gotta do. Inoculation. That's right, inoculation. What you're gonna wanna do is you take this biochar, well, not, it's not biochar yet, it will be, but you take this charcoal and you're gonna bash it down with like a hammer or a sledgehammer in a bucket, and you get it into about pea size, you know, pieces, and you're gonna basically soak it with a fertilizer for a few days. You want there to be enough water to cover it, and you get the fertilizer down in there so that what's gonna happen is all these little nooks and crannies and all these little tunnels that are made are gonna get filled up with that fertilizer. I personally use worm tea, a worm casting tea, and it works great in the garden. You can use whatever you want, but that's what we do. We go straight up organic, and I've found that worm tea is one of the best fertilizers around. And when you combine that with this, you have a powerhouse for your garden. So there it is, folks. I'm Brad with the Big Family Homestead. Please do share the video. It does help our family out. You guys have an amazing day.